People are discussing which actors are best fit to play Miles Morales in the MCU. Ludwig will begin his own spin-off film, and finally, we all continue to ride the Fauci rollercoaster of confusion. I'm Luke Kratzer, and thank you for joining me on The Luke Kratzer Show. Now before I begin, I would like to remind you, if you have not yet subscribed to The Luke Kratzer Show, I do encourage you to do so. And be sure to click the little bell icon, that way you won't miss any of my new content. Okay, on with the show. Well guys, it's official. The multiverse has finally been created in the MCU. So not only will we be seeing Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness coming out soon, but we can furthermore confirm the theory of whether Spider-Man No Way Home will be a live-action Spider-Verse film. We've been waiting for something like this ever since Into the Spider-Verse, and I am really hoping that that theory turns into a reality. However, that's also got me thinking. If there is a chance for us to see a Spider-Verse film, do you think we can be able to see more than just three Spider-Men, at least the ones we know? Maybe it's an opportunity to feature another great Spider-Man. You guessed it, ladies and gentlemen, Miles Morales. Now, I know that we haven't got word that Miles will be featured in the MCU. However, that doesn't mean we shouldn't think that that Marvel wouldn't go that route. Heck, believe it or not, Miles was actually featured in the MCU. Well, technically. You see, if you watch Spider-Man Homecoming, you would be able to find a deleted scene that has Aaron Davis, aka the guy that Spider-Man webbed to a car. And in that scene, you would see Aaron talking on his phone, talking to his nephew, Miles. And if you're a comic book fan, you would know that Aaron Davis is actually the uncle of Miles Morales. Now, although it's a deleted scene, we can at least tell that Marvel is planning on bringing the great character into the MCU. So, I don't think we should be asking whether Miles will be in the MCU or not. Instead, we should be asking who is going to play the role of Miles Morales. There are so many great actors that are more than fit for the role. We just got to find the one that truly fits the mantle of Miles Morales. Luckily, many people agree. So much so that they decided to create an article that features 8 actors that they believe will be fit to play Miles Morales. So today, I'm going to read it to you and while also giving my thoughts and opinions on the actors. So, let's take a look. Okay, first actor. Justice Smith. Now, you've probably seen him in a few kid films. He was in Detective Pikachu and he was also in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. However, he's also been featured in more mature films such as All the Bright Places. He is also part of the show Generation, but we're not going to talk about that. I like him as an actor, it's just I haven't seen him in enough stuff for me to feel super confident in his role. Okay, actor number 2. Renzi Felix. This is an actor that was actually featured in a Marvel TV show, The Runaways. It's not canon to the MCU, but some speculate he might be featured as Miles. Actor 3. RJ Seiler. Now, I've only seen him in one film. He was the Blue Power Ranger in the 2017 Power Rangers movie, which, by the way, is actually okay in my opinion. However, I do believe this guy is a good actor for the role. Out of everyone in the list, he is the only one that I would consider to be perfect for the role as Miles, in my opinion at least. Actor 4. Alex R. Hibbert. Now, I've never seen any movies with this guy, but from what I can see, to me, he just doesn't look too fit for the part. Actor number 5, Taylor James Williams. Okay, this one shouldn't even be an option. This guy looks way too old to be playing Miles. The actor looks older than Tom Holland. So, that's a no for me. Okay, actor number 6, Miles Brown. So, I've never heard of this guy, but from what the article says, people believe he shows an equal amount of humor and wit in his personality. So, people would consider him a great candidate for the role. However, unless someone can shave that disgraceful mustache on his face, there is no way I'm letting him play Miles. Actor number 7, Caleb McLaughlin. Now, this is a guy I'm very familiar with. I know this actor from the show Stranger Things. I'm willing to believe that this guy could do it. I mean, he's smart, witty, and very entertaining as an actor. So, I wouldn't complain if they made him Miles. And last, the final actor, Shameik Moore. Now, the reason why he is on the list is because he was actually the voice actor for Miles Morales from Into the Spider-Verse. With relations to Marvel, he might actually have a bit of an advantage in getting the role. The only thing we have to worry about is if he can play the role in real life as well as he did in the animated film. Okay, so that's all the actors that the article features. Being honest, I liked some of the actors in the article, but I would have to say my favorite pick out of all of them would be RJ Seiler. I just see him as a better actor for the character than the others. But at the end of the day, we still aren't 100% sure who the actual actor is going to be. For all we know, Marvel's probably going to pick an actor we never even heard of. I mean, that's basically what they did do when they brought Tom Holland went into the MCU. So I wouldn't be too surprised if they did that as well. So while I was watching YouTube, I came across a trailer for a movie that I cannot believe is even going to be made. Do you guys remember the movie Army of the Dead? Well, it turns out that there is going to be a spin-off movie starring one of the favorite characters from the film, Ludwig. If you don't remember who that guy was, he was basically the safecracker in the film. Anyway, in this film we get to see a prequel of Ludwig going on his own adventure in the land of the undead. Here's a little bit of the trailer.
This is about becoming legends.
I gotta say, I am really looking forward to this film. Ludwig is a very likable character in the first film, and I am very happy that they are giving him his own movie. However, if you guys know Zack Snyder and you've seen his movies, you can probably guess that just like the first film, it's going to get really dark, really quick. So, as you guys know from recent news, certain figures are once again pushing mask wearing. Even if you are someone who has gotten the COVID vaccine, they still think you should wear the mask. This is coming from Joe Biden, the media, and even the CDC, to name a few. In fact, here is a video of the CDC director saying that even with the vaccine, we should still wear a mask.
In areas with substantial and high transmission, CDC recommends fully vaccinated people wear masks in public, indoor settings to help prevent the spread of the Delta variant and protect others. This includes schools. CDC recommends that everyone in K-12 schools wear a mask indoors, including teachers, staff, students, and visitors, regardless of vaccination status. Children should return to full-time in-person learning in the fall with proper prevention strategies in place.
Now, I don't know about you, but this is beyond confusing to me. First, the CDC says that you should wear the mask until you get the COVID vaccine, right? But now they are just saying that even with the vaccine, you still need to wear a mask. I mean, I just do not get it. Does the vaccine work or not? And if it does work, then doesn't that mean you don't need to wear a mask anymore? Maybe I'm just getting the research from the wrong source, though. Instead, maybe I should ask the greatest doctor of all time, the man himself, Dr. Fauci. I mean, this guy's been informing us about the COVID thing since the beginning it all started. So maybe he can clear things up. Dr. Fauci, what do you think we should all do about this?
Wear a mask indoors if, in fact, you've been vaccinated. Good that you're vaccinated, but in a situation where you have people indoors, particularly crowded, you should wear a mask.
So even if you are vaccinated, you should wear a mask.
That if, in fact, you are vaccinated, fully vaccinated, you are protected, and you do not need to wear a mask outdoors or indoors.
When the children go out into the community, you want them to continue to wear masks.
Insistence now on wearing masks. I mean, masks are very important.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I can clearly understand now. I mean, thank you, Dr. Fauci. Just thank you very much for your help. You clearly know what you're talking about. Well, guys, that is my show for today. If you enjoy my content, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And click the little bell icon, that way you won't miss any of my new content. And before I go, I actually would like to inform you that I will be out of town next week. Therefore, I will not be able to make another episode of the Lucrative Show for you guys. I know it's sad, and I know that you guys are probably going to miss me, but that's just that. But I do promise you, by the time the school year starts again, you will indeed be seeing me again. Anyway, you have been a wonderful audience, and I wish you all a great rest of the summer. I'm Luke Kratzer, and thank you for joining me on the Luke Kratzer Show. Peace out, guys.